Okay, so I'm just going to talk about a question on how to sort of deal with someone who's sort of going into, you know, states of deep unrest or trauma or panic, and how to, if you're with these type of people, how do you deal with that? One of the things to know, I mean, I just share from my own experience of wanting to transcend my mother and living with my mother. And that took a lot of work. What I really want, the essence of it was to not allow them, whatever they said or did, you know, for it not to affect me, to have transcendence around that. It is quite difficult if you're in a, it's kind of an intimate relationship with someone to do that, but it is possible. One of the things is trying not to allow them to hook you into their drama, and either, I mean, I did things like changing the topic or just listening, or just trying to, you know, escape to another room or to the toilet or whatever it is, and just try and process anything that's coming up with them. Also, what I would be doing is having the intention to see how they are hooking me in to their story, and just be cancelling my beliefs and placing them into God's infinite light and love, and praying for miracles around all the hooks. So I'd have a big piece of paper every time they panic and say, what shall I do? I really want to, I'd place my capacity to be disconnected when they're in panic into God's infinite light and love. I'd cancel my belief that when they're panicking, I get disconnected, I'm an infinite being. I'd just be processing these. Every time they're in panic, I could see peace. I would be doing all these processes and have the intention that as I do this work, that even if they're in panic, I stay in this neutral, detached state and don't get hooked into it. So I'd be writing down all the hooks and trying to be making progress through prayer and cancelling around all the hooks. If they're sort of saying, like, I'm in panic, can you join me in my panic? I mean, they wouldn't say that exactly, but sometimes they might say that they try and suck you in to their drama. You really want to be, it's a bit like being a karate black belt, trying to not allow, you know, one of the tactics I used was either to just try and stay in the detached observer and not answer. And that might make them very agitated.